Welcome students, today we will see creation of a 3D model by using pad and pocket in part design. So let's start. So here we have a solid object. So we will create this solid object here in CATIA. So first of all we have to create this object from front face, because this is my front face. So this L shape we need to generate in front view. So here we will be having my front view as this plane, this is my top plane and this is my right plane. So for creating, developing this model, front face is suitable. So we will go for sketch, we will select this front plane so that we will enter into sketcher. So for creating this L shape, we have dimension as height as 70. This length as 60 and thickness is as 10. It is showing here and here. So I will choose here profile command. Exactly from origin I will be clicking over here. I will be picking over here. I will be picking over here. Like this L shape you need to generate. Like this till here. So this is my closed sketch. For applying dimension, we know in constraint itself we have constraint. If you want to repeat constraint, just double click on this, click on the screen, click on the screen, click on this and click on this. Now this object is fully constrained, which is representing in green color. Give escape. This should be, double click on this, this should be 70, and double click on this, this should be 60, double click on this, it should be some 10, and double click on this, this should be 10. The object is looking like small, so you can fit to the screen by using this option. Now you have to exit from the part design, just click on this. Now in sketchbase features itself we have to select here pad for converting the object into a solid. So now this is my object. At this location it is giving some value as 20, but the total length of this component is 35 plus 45 plus 10, means 35 plus 10, 45 plus 45, it is around 90. So what we have to do here, we have to give some 45. So at this side 45 is coming. If you choose mirror extent, so this side it will take 45 as well as other side also it will take 45. So total it will become 90. So you need to apply OK here, click on isometric view for keeping it into isometric view. Now we have to create this side support. This side support having a gap of around from this point to this point of around 10, and from this point to this point it is having around a 10 distance. So but this side support is located at this side face. So here it is available actually on this side. So you need to select this face and you need to go for sketch. So you will be entering into sketcher. Click on this. So you have to create a profile by using profile command. Click on this simple profile. You have to create a triangle. If I want to coincide this and this, just double click on this. Select this one and this one, just press right click for coinciding this. You can coincide like this also. Select this, right click, coincide. But the distance between this point to this point you can assign as 10. So just carefully select this point and this point. Keep here and select this point again, click here. You need to give 10. Double click on this, you need to give 10. Now exit the workbench from this for entering into part design. This is my complete sketch. Now we will select pad option. The pad option is applied on this sketch. Now my solid is coming on this side. I want inside. So change your reverse direction by clicking on this arrow. Otherwise you can click on this also. So the value of around, for this we will be having some 10. Here it is showing as 10. You may give here some as 10 and say preview. and apply. Okay, so one side support is created, but I need support at this location also. So if you need support at this location, so this face you have to select and you have to go for sketch. So now you have entered into Sketcher. Now here previously we have created one support, that support is showing over here. So we have one command in operation toolbar itself. One command is there, project 3D elements. Basically this command is useful for projecting the sketches based on the solid. Suppose already we have a solid, so you just need to select this project 3D element. If I keep my cursor here, so if you click there, whatever the sketch is, whatever the solid is available over there, based on that solid it will create a new sketch at this location like this. You can exit the workbench or else you can delete this, make it normal view. Now suppose when I am selecting this project 3D element, if I am selecting one particular edge, so only on that particular edge one new line will be created. But if you need to create the whole sketch, what you have to do, you have to go here, project 3D elements, keep your cursor, the whole area will highlight. Basically it will project the solid and it will develop a sketch. You just click over here, no need of creating a complete sketch and applying constraint, it is not required. Now go for exit workbench. So already we have a sketch over here, make it isometric view. Go for pad, select the pad and change the reverse direction to this side, apply value as 10 and apply OK. So now we got two supports. Now we have to create two holes, this hole and this hole. For creating these two holes, we will be using option here as pocket. So first of all, one hole is available on this wall. So on this space, it is available a hole of size some 35 mm and this is 15. So it is available on this space, means I need to select this space, go for sketch. Now we will choose here centered rectangle. You may keep your cursor exactly at center so that our rectangle will come exactly at center. Click on this, double click on this constraint, select on this for applying length, select on this for applying the breadth, and the distance between this edge and this center point, it is showing around some 20. So you need to select this edge and the center point of the rectangle and click on here, double click on this, give some 20. This is around 35 and this is around some 15. Now exit from the sketcher. Now if you want to make a hole, you have to select pocket and give, it is 10, so you may give 10 only, apply OK. So now we got a hole over here. One more hole is available on this face. Go for sketch, select this face. So now you have entered into Sketcher. Now we will use centered rectangle exactly at the center. I will click here. So this box is having some 15 length and breadth at a distance of 25. Double click on this, click over here and click over here. From this to this, it is 25. Click on this. Double click on this, it should be 25. Double click on this, it should be 15. Again, this is also 15. Exit workbench, make it isometric view, again go for pocket, select this sketch and it should be 10 mm and apply OK. So this is what we have created, our object 3D model by using pad and pocket. In next lecture we will see creation of one more 3D model by using pad and pocket in part design. Thank you.